Y'all ready?
Hi, it's me, Shereene from Upside Down Smilie. We're here with the Upside Down Smilie Show, where we talk about real life, but we don't take life too seriously. I have my friend Sharris here. Sharris, tell them what you are up to about your life.
Well, by day, I'm a creative recruiter, so I help people get jobs. And then outside of that job, I do Canvas Wed, which is weddings and event design. And yeah.
And then she helps me.
And then I help Shereene
with like coordination. And then she like my soul sister. And she's planning her own wedding right now, which is really cool.
Yeah, and that.
I want to talk about having babies and, you know, like the pressures and like the whole like mind in preparation of having babies. Mm-hmm. So yeah. Sharris is 34 years young and I am 32. And I think we're kind of at the age where people kind of expect us to have kids. A lot of our friends and people in our lives are having kids. Have people been bringing it up to you more as you are getting older?
Yeah. My new pet peeve has been when people are like, oh, when are you guys gonna have kids? Because you never know. Like, I think it's almost rude to ask that. I mean, I get it. Some people don't mean anything, any harm by it, or like they're excited for like that next step for you. But like, you just never know if someone can't have kids, or like if it's just like a personal or private choice that them and their partner have made. So that has, like, I feel like people have been asking us that, especially since we've gotten engaged. Mm-hmm. But basically ever since I feel like I turned 30, like, I've gotten so much pressure from my family. Like, how come you're not pregnant? My grandma, every time I get sick, everybody knows this about my nene. Every time I get sick, if I have a cold, she's like, are you pregnant?
Yeah. We've been talking about it more. Like, you know, I've been thinking about it more because I'm seeing babies and having like a different kind of feeling. Mm-hmm. And I think I've always loved babies because like babies are cute, but now it's looking at babies and being like, I want that too. Mm-hmm. Are you having those feelings as well?
I think I've always wanted to be a mom. I just never knew when. And I don't think you can always 100% say now is the right time.
Yeah.
But I've had those feelings more and more. And I think a lot of it comes from also knowing that like Eddie is like the guy.
Yeah. I was thinking about like, you know, knowing when you're ready. And I know that you're never gonna feel like 100% ready. But I think for me, there's a lot of things going on. Like I'm in like a transition period with my career. And I feel like with what me and my husband do, a lot of time and energy has to be put towards it. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of feelings about pregnancy. I'm like really scared of the idea of being pregnant. I know like it's gonna be a beautiful thing, like there's like a child growing in you, like that bond and whatnot.
Yeah.
But like, it's a huge sacrifice. I wish that we could take turns. I wish that we could like be like, okay, this time I'll do it.
Hey, you got this.
And next time you got it. And then we might be good. And like that also makes me think about like, do I wanna go through it more than once? And I know like the whole process hasn't even started. But I think about this quite a bit. And I think it's also as I'm getting older, I'm getting really tired. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, man, how am I tired with just a job and like trying to see family and trying to do all the things and be social and like take care of myself? Like, how am I gonna do that with a baby?
Yeah, I think about the same thing. I don't even have time to take care of myself.
Right.
I could barely put my own shoes on.
I like work out once a month. Like, that's like not even reality. Like, I work out less than once a month. But then you hear, you know, it just all gets done. Everything somehow happens because, like, there's a human depending on you to, like, live.
Yeah.
And then also, I've also heard, like, it's better to do it when you get older. Who knows how long it's going to take to get pregnant, right? Like, a lot of people I know, they just, like, get pregnant and then they have families and then, like, they always look tired. And I'm like, y'all ain't selling it. Like, y'all ain't making me want to have kids. And I don't know. I think I wanted to talk about this just to kind of like keep it real. I think a lot of women have a lot of fears with this. I think a lot of women are like going through it during pregnancy, while they have kids, while they have babies. But I don't know if they're really talking about it.
And people feel like alone and, you know, I mean, I know there's like other like groups out there, but then think about like what we were just saying, like a lot of our friends are already like past that stage or like past that age. So some of them, like, you feel like weird having those conversations with them about it,
right?
Or, you know, like,
yeah,
they don't really understand. But at the same time, I'm looking at my friends like, I didn't really understand when you had a baby when you were like 25, 26. I didn't know how to relate to you either.
Right. I know that there's going to be a lot of time and energy that go into like raising a child, but I also want to have a life.
Yeah.
Because I think that has a lot to do with like taking care of yourself so you can be whole to take care of a child and set an example of like, you know, what they should be doing when they become adults. Bringing your kids to do things and, like, in, you know, also, like, still interacting with other adults. And I know that's going to be a challenge, but, mm-hmm. like, trying to figure out that balance.
Yeah. We've had this conversation, too, because I think, especially when we moved away, when we mm-hmm. moved to Milwaukee, I felt like I was really, like, isolated because we didn't know anyone there.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I was still in that, also that weird wedge of, like, okay, we don't know anyone, but I'm also trying to, like, pivot, like, where my career is going.
Try to focus.
Yeah. And I just felt like and this is, like, this goes back to, like, taking turns, too, but, you know, I told Eddie, like, I'm really focused in building this, like, business. Like, I haven't even, like, given that its full potential yet, and that's something that like is still like down the line. And I also, like, you know, I don't want to sound selfish with it, but like I want him to take the opportunities to grow too with you know, the things that he does in design and seeing where that goes. But at the same time, I'm like, you know, I almost feel like there's this like expiration date, you know,
for sure,
because it's like once you become a mom, like, not saying that your life ends, but those things definitely have to be put on pause, and you can't put as much energy towards those things.
And sometimes I feel like a sense of guilt, like, I always say, like, to me, family is, like, number one priority, but, like, and then I feel like I question myself all the time, like, but are my actions aligned to that? Like, do I, like, my parents live 45 minutes away, and I probably see them, like, once a month, and I don't feel like that's enough. And then, like, if I'm saying, you know, my immediate family, like the family I'm creating with Sanu, is priority, then, like, why haven't I started that process?
Just like all the women before us, like,
yeah.
I think you just have to, like, it's just gonna happen, you know, like, and you figure it out as it goes. Like, I don't think that there's all the self-help books that are out there, and this truck that's beeping.
Shout out to the truck that's beeping in the background, and the trains. I used to, like, take breaks for the trains, but I'm like, the trains are way too frequent.
It's Chicago, it's fine.
You can have a plan for everything. You can have a plan for your pregnancy, you can have a plan for your birth, you can have a plan for your children, but, like, nothing's gonna go as planned.
Yeah, you can't plan nothing
like,
else.
Like, I plan to be ready with my camera and my lights at 9 a.m. when Sharris came, but when she came, I was in my towel.
I also plan to be not hungover.
But, like, as women, I think we just put so much pressure on ourselves to be perfect. And, like, I'm big about, like, not, you know, trying to, like, put this perfect image, because, like, that's just not attainable. But we still, like, are trying to be as perfect as we can, and
trying to piece it together so, like, you don't make mistakes or feel like you're missing anything. The big thing about it is I think that we have such a good group of friends, or like a good community. I think that that is one thing that over probably the last like 2 years, I think that I found comfort in that. But I feel like if I ever need anything, like, you guys are right down the street. Like, not saying you would be my like babysitter or like, my
first. I ain't gonna be a full-time babysitter. I ain't gonna be a living nanny. It takes a village, like, and I want my kids to be raised around a community. We're so lucky and blessed to have, like, really good people around us.
Yeah.
I don't even know what the wrap up is about having babies. But basically, one day we're gonna be ready to have babies, and